Owners know those furry creatures are members of our families. And if you have an aging pet that's experiencing discomfort or your younger pet has been injured, there are a number of ways to help them best deal with the pain. Here today is Dr. Leslie Smith from the UW School of Veterinary Medicine. Thank you so much for being here. And who is this?
This is my girl, Wilma.
Who is just giving you kisses as I was talking about how they're a part of our family. You're so smart. It was perfect.
She is part of our family.
Let's talk about first the acute pain. Mm-hmm. What causes that and what are the best ways to treat it?
Acute pain in pets is the same as it is for people, usually associated with surgery or trauma. A good example for a pet would be a dog that gets hit by a car, mm-hmm. would suffer some acute pain associated with that injury, potentially broken bones. Or even just routine surgeries that we think of for pets, like being spayed and neutered, would cause acute pain.
Let's talk about chronic pain. And so, and we're looking at Wilma here, who's a young and vibrant 10 years old, right? My dog's 9 and a half. At what age do you believe that chronic pain becomes a concern?
Well, you can see chronic pain at any age, but in a younger animal, it usually would be associated with some sort of injury that either was not treated at the time, or maybe there's a complication associated with the treatment. Mm-hmm. So that animal might start to develop chronic pain just because of the prior injury. But more typically, we see chronic pain in animals as they age, just like in people, osteoarthritis being probably one of the most common types of chronic pain.
And that would be around what age should we be aware of
it? It really depends on the species and the breed. So older or giant breed dogs or large breed dogs are older when they reach 7 or 8 years old. A smaller breed dog like Wilma, I would consider her still to be middle-aged. So smaller breeds tend to get age-related problems a little later in life.
And one of the newer treatments for pain is acupuncture for pets. We have some video. Talk about, maybe your opinion about using this as a tool for pets.
Acupuncture is actually really ancient. It's not new at all, but it's reaching modern veterinary medicine and kind of more traditional Western veterinary medicine increasingly these days. I think it's a very useful adjunct for treating pain, especially chronic pain in animals. The other area that acupuncture is really useful for in pets is neurologic problems, so disc compression. Small breeds of dogs that are long-backed, like dachshunds, can get disc compression, which can cause muscle weakness, inability to use their hind limbs very well.
And we have some photos, because this is not just used for dogs.
Mm-hmm. Correct. We use it for horses, cows. We have the rare cat that responds well to acupuncture. Horses are actually very good responders to acupuncture. And acupuncture in horses can actually be used as a diagnostic tool to find areas of discomfort or lameness that haven't been diagnosed by traditional methods.
Doctor, thank you so much for being here. We appreciate it. And we want to let everybody know that if you'd like to learn more about the services offered at UW Veterinary Care, which is the Veterinary Medical Hospital, log on to our web channel, click on News Links. We'll be right back.